As you will soon see, the trombone section has been waiting for this next piece. It's called Lassus Trombone. It's written by a gentleman named Henry Fillmore, and if you've been here at concerts before, you know Henry Fillmore's father thought trombones were sinful, but actually not as sinful as trumpets. So we're going to play what Henry Fillmore wrote for the trombones, and you'll understand why we love him, and I want you to think whether we're right or not. Lassus Trombone. Before we do this, I want you all, if you could, to help the band a little bit. We have a contribution bucket up front that's being danced around, but we would appreciate a little help to help us through the year. We have a few costs. All of us are volunteers, and to get through the costs, we need a little outside help, even from the Atlanta Braves. Now, for all of you kids and grown-ups, we have a polka. Do you kids know how to do a polka? Then do it, whether you know or not. It's called a Swing-A-Roo polka. Believe it or not, it comes from Holland, the country of Holland. It's by a gentleman named Zane van Auken. And we have just proved that the Dutch like polkas also. So here we go, Swing-A-Roo polka. Bogey March. Now let me remind you, this is written by a British Grandmaster in 1914. It's based on a military friend of his who whistled two notes when he, rather than say four, on the golf course. Those two notes you'll hear over and over again in the march. It became the Colonel Bogey March because back in the days when it was written, a bogey was a par, and you played against Colonel Bogey to play a par. Now that's all changed today for you golfers, but that's history you can take to the golf course and talk about. This is one of the most popular marches, of the three most popular marches ever written. The other two, Stars and Stripes Forever and the Radetzky March. Thank you.
Thank you.